Hello guys, Neapple Times here, welcome to a new video, and today I'm gonna show you how you can use your iPad as a second monitor for Windows. Okay, so if you have a Mac, you probably know about Sidecar, this option that has been available for a few years actually, and lets you use your iPad as a second display for Mac. Now this is built into Apple's ecosystem, so all you have to do is hold one button and then it will automatically connect to the iPad. There's even no need to connect any physical cables or anything, it just does it over Wi-Fi. But that is not the case with Windows, of course, which can be really annoying because, for example, I'm the biggest Apple fan, but for work I was given a Windows laptop and sometimes I want a second screen or even a third screen and I just would like to connect my iPad. But thankfully, it is actually possible. So today I'm gonna show you not one, but two ways you can use to connect your iPad to your Windows laptop. So the first way is using Duet Display. This app has been available for a long time, actually longer than the Mac has had a Sidecar, so I used to use it with the Mac before, but now it's also available for Windows. Now we'll talk about pricing a little bit after the video, but now let's go and see how it works. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is on your iPad, go to the App Store and download Duet Display. Now this will be about a $10, don't know the exact price, but I think it's around $10 to download and it's a one-time purchase. We'll talk more about price later. Then once you have downloaded it on your iPad, go to duetdisplay.com on your Windows computer or Mac and scroll almost all the way down until you see Be Productive on one of your devices. Then here you will click Duet for Windows 10 Plus and it will download on your computer. Then once you have it, you probably need to open and install it and everything. Then you need to connect your iPad to your computer and you might need to click Trust on your iPad and you're almost ready. Now go to Duet and once you connect, you will see that it has automatically connected by, for example, taking your pages from one screen to another and doing everything that a second display should do. Then some troubleshooting tips in case it's not working for you. Make sure your Duet app is updated and then close it and open it again and try connecting the computer once the Duet app is open on your iPad. And that should do it with Duet Display. Now we'll talk about pricing a little further down the video, but the second option is actually with a video capture device. Once you have this video capture device, you can download the Orion app. Don't worry, I'll show you in detail in a moment. But then you can use the iPad as a secondary monitor. And the great thing about this option is that first of all the app is free and second of all it not only works with Windows computers but also with pretty much anything you can connect via HDMI. That includes of course your camera, your Nintendo Switch, your Xbox, your PS5, whatever. But first of all let me show you how it works. Now for the second method you will not need anything to download on your Windows computer but you will need some extra hardware. First of all, you will need something like this. This is a video capture HDMI to USB-C. I'll put a link in the description below in case you want to pick up one for yourself and help out the channel. But yeah, this is really simple. It basically converts HDMI to USB-C. That's what you will need for your iPad. And then you will need an HDMI to HDMI cable or whatever output your Windows laptop has. Then you will need to go to your iPad and download this app, which is called HDMI Monitor Orion. And once you have it, you can open it and then connect everything. So connect the HDMI to the video capture, then to your Windows laptop, and finally the video capture to your iPad. And as you can see again, I can use the mouse here and basically it's a second screen for my monitor. Now I personally like this option better, just because when you buy that extra hardware and this app, you're set to go forever. And worst case scenario, if this app were ever to be a payment app, I'm sure there will be others available on the App Store. But yeah, that was the second option. Now let's go ahead and finish the video. Okay, so as you saw, it's really simple to use your iPad as a second monitor on your Windows with either of these two options. Now for Duet Display, the pricing is a bit tricky. I bought this app years ago, like easily 10 years ago, and I paid up around 10 euro for it, I think. They have since introduced a lot of new plans with different options, such as using your iPad as a graphic tablet for like drawing on your computer or whatever, and those are subscription only services. Now trying to look into the website to see the pricing was actually a bit confusing, so here's how I think it works. Basically you have to purchase your app on your iPad for around $10 and that allows you to use your iPad as a second monitor with either Windows or Mac using a cable. Now there's different plans that allow you to do other things, such as I said, use your iPad as a graphic tablet to draw on your computer, sharing the display over Wi-Fi so you wouldn't need a cable, and other things. For this, however, you have to get one of these plans that are subscription only. And prices range from around $4 to $8 a month, I think. But yeah, it's definitely really confusing. But yeah, with the video capture device, it's actually really simple. All you need to do is get this cable, which is around $15. You might find it. I'll leave a link down below in the description if you wanna get it and help out the channel. Then the Orion app is actually free, so we could consider it again a one-time purchase of the actual video capture device. However, this method only works with those iPads that support USB-C. If you want to connect your Lightning iPad, you will need to use Duet Display. So yeah, that was everything I wanted to show you today. Hopefully everything was clear, but if it wasn't and you still have any questions, please let me know down below in the comments and I will do my best to answer. If you found this video helpful, please thumbs up, and if you want to see more Apple related videos, don't forget to subscribe because I post some every week. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Twitter and TikTok for more Apple content. But yeah, thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!